Zaxby's has been perfecting chicken fingers for 30 years. So what now? Now we go to the sea. Introducing the Southern Fried Shrimp Meal with butterfly shrimp that's perfectly golden fried. A perfect blend of cocktail sauce and Zax sauce that we call Zax Tail Sauce. Plus perfectly seasoned crinkle fries, perfectly buttery Texas toast, and even a drink with perfectly pebbled ice. Here's to 30 more years of perfect. The new Southern Fried Shrimp Meal at Zaxby's. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
Joe Dredge.
The show goes on!
Mornings on WROK. Over 95 years in the books and still on top. This is Rockford's News Talk 1440 WROK.
7 minutes after six, News Talk 1440 WROK. It's Riley and Joe. It's a Wednesday morning. Glad to have you with us. It's cloudy this morning and 57 degrees, but clouds are going to give way to a nicer day. We have absolutely no wind going on, so no feels like. Humidity's at 91%. We're looking at a daytime high today of 83. Partly sunny skies and only a 3% chance of any precipitation.
Not bad.
Not bad for a Wednesday. Tomorrow, partly sunny and 85 with a 10% chance. Friday's all sun all day and 80 with a 5%. Saturday's all sun all day and 85 with a 6%. And then Monday, or rather Sunday, we're at partly sunny skies, 87 and about a 20% chance of precipitation.
Love it.
So, looks like we're going to dry out here a little bit over the next few days, and good temperatures, and should see a peak of some sun, too.
A lot better than yesterday.
Enough of that. Yeah. That was an anti-motivational day.
It really was.
It really was. At least it was for me.
Let's not do anything.
Yeah, I didn't really feel like much of anything yesterday.
Not particularly.
So, today we'll try to make up for that with some nicer weather. But right now, you're just sitting under 57 degrees under partly cloudy skies.
Very cool.
So, have a look at the almanac for Wednesday, June 14th, 165th day of the year. 200 days remain in 2023. Today's highlight in history, we have a rare double highlight
really?
In history. Yeah, this doesn't happen all the time. It was on this date in 1775. The Continental Army, the forerunner of the United States Army, was created. So, happy birthday, United States Army, founded on this date, 1775, when the Continental Congress authorized enlistment of expert riflemen to serve the United Colonies for 1 year.
Good job,
yep.
Army.
Part two of the double highlight in history, it was on this date in 1777, when the Second Continental Congress approved the design of the original American flag. Oh. That's why today is Flag Day. There you go. Good. So a couple of really worthy double highlights in history. Happy birthday, U.S. Army, and congratulations to the flag for getting the approval.
Very, very nice.
On this date, 1846, a group of U.S. settlers in Sonoma proclaimed the Republic of California. They had a little bear design. They just needed someplace to put it.
They did.
1911, the British ocean liner RMS Olympic set out on its maiden voyage for New York, arrived a week later. The ship's captain was a guy named Edward John Smith. He went on to command the Titanic a year later.
Not successful.
That was the end of his career, yes, by the way. Yeah, it was all over with from there. 1919 on this day, John Alcock and Arthur Witten Brown embarked on the first nonstop flight across the Atlantic Ocean. For anybody going, well, wait a minute, what about Lindbergh? I thought Lindbergh was the first. No, Lindbergh was the first solo. Yep, these guys did it in tandem.
How long did it say how long that took?
It doesn't say.
Okay.
It doesn't say. I'd have to look that one up.
What, like a 12-hour trip?
Oh, probably more than that. Yeah, even more than that. Yeah, probably 18 along those lines. Yeah, Lindbergh, I think, was about that point. Not an easy, and the first two guys to do it. It's a lot of water to fly over.
A lot of water.
Yeah, if things go wrong, it's not like we had a state-of-the-art Navy or Coast Guard to come out there and help you either. You're screwed.
It's not even like the Pacific where there's little dots of islands to emergency land on.
Yeah,
there's really nothing out there.
You got nothing. On this day, 1940, German troops entered Paris during World War II, the same day the Nazis began transporting prisoners to the Auschwitz concentration camp in German-occupied Poland. Seized control of Paris imposed an 8 p.m. curfew that was broadcast to all of the citizens over the entire city via loudspeakers. Last-minute discussions between French Premier Paul Renault, British Prime Minister Winston Churchill, and President FDR encountered opposition to the suggestion they help France. That came from his Secretary of State, Cordell Hull. Well, they ended up not helping France. By the time the announcements were made, the German forces arrived. 2 million Parisians had already abandoned the city. Those who remained faced capture, questioning, and investigation by the Gestapo. Then they went and draped a giant swastika over the Arc de Triomphe.
Okay. Didn't go over well.
Yeah, that was really nice. Government acted immediately. Ours did anyway, freezing all American assets in Germany, Italy, and amongst the Axis powers. Okay. So that was on this date in 1940. That. 1943, the U.S. Supreme Court and West Virginia State Board of Education v. Barnett ruled 6-3 public school students could not be forced to salute the flag of the United States. Okay. 1954 on this date, President Eisenhower signed a measure adding the phrase, under God, to the Pledge of Allegiance. Mm-hmm. 72 on this date, the EPA ordered a ban on the domestic use of the pesticide DDT, and that was to take effect at the end of the year. Mm-hmm. I remember several neighbors, my grandfather as well, kept his supply.
Stockpile a little
bit? Yo, big time. Okay. Big time. Because, you know, the thing about that stuff is, it worked.
It worked very well.
Yep. Mm-hmm. 1982 on this date, Argentine forces surrendered to British troops on the disputed Falkland Islands. 2005 on this date, Michelle Wie, at the age of 15, became the first female player to qualify for an adult male U.S. Golf Association Championship, tying for first place in a 36-hole U.S. amateur public links sectional qualifying tournament.
She was a phenom.
At 15 years old, hitting a ball 320 yards off the tee.
She was like 6'1 at 15. Too.
Yeah, very, very tall. Yep. And really knew how to use that height to really accentuate that swing. And has been a marvelous player ever since.
She really has. Yeah.
Yep. 10 years ago on this date, the Associated Press reported Minnesota resident Michael Karkrens had been a top commander of a Nazi SS-led unit accused of burning villages filled with women and children and then lying to American immigration officials to get into the United States after World War II. He died on the 14th of December 2019, according to cemetery and public records, at the age of 100.
Okay.
It was 10 years ago on this date as well. Major League Baseball came down hard on the Dodgers and Diamondbacks, handing out 8 suspensions and a dozen fines as punishment for a bench-clearing brawl that happened on June 11th.
Forgetting this one. Dodgers-Diamondbacks?
Dodgers-Diamondbacks, June 11th of 2013. I don't remember that at all. But, apparently noteworthy enough that it makes this day in history.
2013?
Because, 2013. 8 suspensions and a dozen fines, punishment for a bench-clearing brawl. So, all right, there's some video of it. And
this happened quick.
Yeah.
Oh, Zach Greinke's in the middle of it all.
So you got an insane guy in the middle of all of it.
Zach Greinke.
That'll make it better.
Zach Greinke. Insane's not the right word for Zach Greinke.
No, eccentric.
Eccentric is the
eccentric.
Absolutely.
He is wealthy, after all. Yes, if you're poor, you're insane. If you're wealthy, you're eccentric.
Oh, man, this was a good fight. You got guys tumbling into dugouts. This isn't a baseball fight where people are running away from each other.
No, you got guys literally throwing punches and connecting, going after one another. And
that's Matt Williams holding back. That's a bench coach for the Diamondbacks holding back Don Mattingly, the coach of the Dodgers. You know, all hell has broken loose when opposing teams are holding each other back from the umpire.
Yep.
Like, this is real.
Yep. You need to stop, dude.
We're not joking.
You're
going to
sink all of us if you keep doing this. But, Major League Baseball, having none of it after that event 10 years ago on this day. It was 5 years ago. AT&T and Time Warner completed their merger, one of the biggest media deals ever, 2 days after a federal judge approved the combination. Also five years ago.
That worked out well for everybody, right? All those huge mergers just works well for the general population.
Yeah, everybody, saved everyone money, gave them better content. Yeah. Boy, you couldn't ask for more.
Nope.
5 years ago as well on this date, betting on pro sports became legal in New Jersey. New Jersey had fought for 8 years against a federal law that limited sports betting to Nevada, Delaware, Montana, and Oregon. Well, that was squeezing the toothpaste out of the tube there.
I was
going to
say,
genie out of the bottle.
Your toothpaste saying applies just so well to that one. There's no going back.
Nope.
There's
no going back
now, and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars of advertising revenue going out from all of these gambling sites. You're not going to get that stopped.
Yep.
It was a year ago in the state, raging floodwaters that pulled houses into rivers and forced rescues by air and boat across the Yellowstone region began to recede, but tourists and others were still stranded after roads and bridges had been knocked out by torrential rainfall. Remember some of the video of that? Yeah. People, you're visiting Yellowstone, and the next thing you get, I need a rescue.
Yeah, I can't drive out.
I can't drive out, and there's animals that will eat me if I try to walk out. So somebody want to come and help me?
Please.
It's also a year ago in the state, New York's top court rejected an effort to free Happy the elephant from the Bronx Zoo. The court decided Happy the elephant did not meet the definition of a person who was being illegally confined against her will.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I had some people who wanted the elephant turned loose of her own volition because she was a person who was being illegally confined. Okay. Court said, yeah, I don't think so. Let's go on to some more important business.
Good job, courts.
Right. Yeah. There you go. Over to the birthday list. Yeah, are we done? Can we? Okay, where's my gavel? All right, birthdays. If today's your big day, happy birthday. Leading off the birthday list, you have actress Marla Gibbs, who is 92. Goes all the way back to the Jeffersons on the show Amen and many other things. Marla Gibbs, really good. 92 years old. Singer Rod Argent of the Zombies and the group Argent. He is 78. Singer Janet Lennon of the Singing Lennon Sisters at 77. Actor Will Patton is 69. Olympic gold medal speed skater Eric Heiden is 65. Singer Boy George, here's another guy. In spite of all of his best efforts, Boy George is having yet another birthday. He is 62 today.
He's only 62, man. He was young when he came on the scene.
Very young. Yeah, young 20s. Actress Traylor Howard at 57. Yasmin Bleeth at 57. International Tennis Hall of Famer Steffi Graf is 54. Screenwriter Diablo Cody is 45. Actor-singer Kevin McHale at 35. Not the former Celtic.
Not the Celtic?
Okay. Not the former Celtic.
He's older than 45,
yeah, I believe. He is. Yeah. So Kevin McHale, actor-singer at 35. Lucy Hale, actress at 34. And if you remember Spy Kids, he was the boy of the Spy Kids. Yeah. Daryl Sabara, he's 31 today. And there's your birthday list and almanac for June 14th of 2023.
It sounds like your kids were writing the demo for Spy Kids.
Big.
Okay, all right, because I'm not familiar with Spy Kids at all.
Love Spy Kids. Danny Trejo in them.
Oh, Danny Trejo's in those?
Is their uncle. And the kids wondered why I was as into Spy Kids with them as I was. Well, it was because Danny Trejo was in it.
Yeah, Danny Trejo shows up, I'll be watching.
I'm in.
I'll be watching.
I am absolutely in if Danny Trejo shows up. So yeah, Spy Kids and Spy Kids 2, 3, I think there might have been a series of them.
Is that his only kids movie?
Who?
Danny Trejo?
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. He may be in others. But I just remember being delighted to see him walk onto the screen, and I didn't know he was in the movie.
I bet he's wonderful in kids' movies. I bet he's wonderful with the kids.
Apparently, the kids really enjoyed being around him.
He's a, you know, I mean, listen, Danny Trejo's got a past.
Yes, he does.
He's got a past. Mm-hmm. But a really sweet guy. Have you seen him mess around with, like, his chihuahuas?
Oh, yeah. He's a terrific guy and is really one of those guys who talks to people who have been in trouble about not getting into trouble.
Yes, no, and that's a
about because he can speak, he can walk the walk, he did time.
Yes,
you know, this isn't discussing this in the abstract for Danny Trejo. No, he's been there.
I can tell you exactly. I know how you got here. Yep. I know how you can get out.
I know how you get out if you'll just listen to me.
Just listen to me.
A bunch of people do listen to him.
Well, listen to Danny Trejo.
Yep.
He starts talking to you, yeah.
And what, are you going to walk away?
No.
That's a guy I definitely would like to spend some time with.
Great role. He's got a great role in Breaking Bad, too. Tortuga. El Tortuga is his name. And
let me guess. Bad guy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. His head ends up on a turtle.
Okay.
And then the turtle blows up.
Oh, and then the turtle blows up. Okay.
Yeah. All right. Spoiler alert.
So the kids loved him, and they loved him in Spy Kids. They, you know, well, they're old enough now. Let them go ahead and watch it.
Yeah, yeah. Let them see what happened to him later on in life.
What happened to Uncle Danny from Spy Kids? Well, there's a funny thing with a turtle.
Yeah.
Yeah, 620 News Talk 1440 WROK. The
Over 95 years in the books and still on top. This is Rockford's News Talk 1440 WROK.
635 News Talk 1440 WROK. Wednesday morning, Riley and Joe, partly cloudy skies and 58 is what's happening right now. Winds are calm, humidity's at 90%. Looking at a daytime high today of 83. Chance of precipitation, although it looks cloudy like it could rain. Nope, 3%. That's all we're looking at today.
Okay.
Now, that could change at some point, but as we look at it now, 3% partly sunny. Tomorrow, 85 and partly sunny with a 10% chance. Friday and Saturday are all sun all day. Friday's 80, Saturday's 85. Sunday could get a little rain now. We've got a 30% chance and 87 are expected high.
Okay.
So that's what's coming up as far as weather goes.
We'll be waiting for it.
Yeah, we can live with it. Some notes on people and their health.
Okay.
Okay. We start out locally here. Okay. Lake Barrington.
Sure.
Lake Barrington, man. Can I just, I'm still trying to, let me read it to you, and I'm trying to figure out how this happens. Lake Barrington, man, with a revoked FOID card.
Okay.
All right. Let's cover that quickly.
Sure, sure, sure.
Fire owner's identification card. Mm-hmm. You don't have one. You can't buy weapons and ammunition. You have one. You've done something wrong. They take it from you. You're not allowed to have the firearm. Or the ammunition.
How wrong of a thing do you have to do to get that?
You know, I don't know what cause for revoking is. It could be any of those red flag laws. Okay. It could be any number of things. I'm not really sure what this guy in particular did to get his FOID card revoked. Mm-hmm. Nonetheless, this guy from Lake Barrington has got a revoked FOID card, arrested and charged after he accidentally shot himself while dreaming. According to the Lake County Sheriff's Office, deputies say they responded to a report of a person with a gunshot wound at about 9:50 p.m. on April 10th. When deputies arrived at the home, they found 62-year-old Mark DeCara with a gunshot wound to his leg. Deputies applied a tourniquet quickly to his leg because he was losing a significant amount of blood. Further investigation revealed DeCara had a dream that someone was breaking into his home. In his dream, he retrieved his .357 Magnum revolver and shot at who he believed was the intruder. When he fired, he shot himself instead, and I like this, and apparently woke up from the dream.
Well, yeah. Yeah, that will do it.
Slap someone in the face sometime when they're asleep. They'll wake up.
That's when you pop out of it.
Gunshot wound probably works even quicker.
Yeah, probably.
There's noise, there's pain, there's smoke. Yeah you're probably going to wake up, even if you're the heaviest of sleepers.
That's interesting.
Taken to a local hospital, treated for his wounds, then released, confirmed there was no burglary at his home. Deputies learned DeCara had a revoked FOID card, yet still possessed a firearm, leading the Lake County State's Attorney's Office approving charges of possession of a firearm without a valid FOID card, which is a Class 3 felony, and reckless discharge of a firearm, which is a Class 4 felony. Warrant drafted on Friday, arrested and processed on Tuesday of this week. Which would be yesterday.
Okay.
Released on bail, $150,000 after posting bond due in court on June 29th.
Okay. Mr. McCarrick.
DeCara.
DeCara, Mr. DeCara. Obviously, I wonder if he had sleeping problems before. That's a sleep disorder, isn't it?
I would think.
Getting up and doing things like that.
Well, yeah. I mean, fishing your gun out while you're asleep and firing it.
Unless he was just sleeping with it on the nightstand.
Even then, you're still reaching over to grab it and fire it in your dream. I don't know what you're aiming at in your dream. Obviously, you were aiming straight down, you're a guy, there's many things that could have been worse.
Could have been a lot worse. What if you fired it in bed? Laying down still?
I'm guessing.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm guessing.
All right.
I like after all of that hospital, guy's hurt and everything. Hey, wait a minute. His FOID card's over. Let's arrest him. You know, the guy really, he's kind of been punished enough at this point, I think. He's had a really bad day.
If you have your FOID card revoked, you can't own anything, right?
You're not supposed to have weapons.
It's not just taking it out of the house.
Having it in there either.
Not having it in there either.
Right. Okay. Right.
All right. Well, he's got some explaining to do.
I, once again, as a gun guy, don't get that one. Don't get that one at all. You're having problems like that where you will wake up and do things. You know, having a firearm anywhere near you at that point is really a bad idea.
Keep that locked in the other room.
Really a bad idea.
You want to make it maybe a little difficult to
get
to.
Yeah, maybe have the gun safe where you got your lay your hand on it, do the biometrics, it makes a noise, all of those things, hopefully enough to wake you up.
Any note in there if he's living by himself?
It doesn't say.
Okay.
It does not talk about any other person in this and as though they were threatened. It doesn't mention another soul. So
just imagine if he's sharing that bed with somebody.
Oh, God. Right. I cannot imagine what I would be saying to Amy at this point.
That's a fight.
Yeah. You're probably wondering how this happened.
You did what in bed?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay. Sorry about that.
You ruined the sheets.
Part two, people and their health. We go to Ecuador for this one. 76-year-old woman declared dead at a hospital in Ecuador, astonished her relatives by...
not being dead?
Knocking on the lid of her coffin during her wake. Incident has prompted a government investigation into the hospital. Relatives left the coffin behind, rushed retired nurse Bella Montoya back to the hospital after the wake on Friday. It gave us all a fright, according to her son Gilberto, adding that doctors had said his mom's situation is still dire. Ecuador's health ministry said Montoya was in intensive care Monday at the hospital while the ministry investigates doctors involved in her case. Blah, 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 blah. Initially had been admitted Friday at the hospital with a possible stroke and cardiopulmonary arrest. When she did not respond to resuscitation, a doctor on duty declared her to be dead. Mr. Barbera says his mom was unconscious when she was brought to the emergency room, that a few hours later a doctor informed them she was dead and handed over identity documents and a death certificate. The family then brought her body to a funeral home or holding a wake later on Friday when they began to hear strange noises. Quote, there were about 20 of us in there. After about 5 hours of the wake.
5 hours?
5 hours.
It's a long wake, by the way.
What are you, Irish?
Right.
The coffin began making noises. My mom was wrapped up in sheets and was tapping on the lid of the coffin when we approached, we could see she was still breathing. Rushed her back to the hospital, still in serious condition as of yesterday. Under intubation, doctors weren't giving relatives much hope about her prognosis. No details have been released about the doctor who declared her dead when she wasn't.
I don't know what the legal system is down in Ecuador, but that happens in America. Somebody's paying some serious legal fees for some pain and suffering.
And should. Yeah, that doesn't seem the sort of mistake. Oh, well, everybody, that happens all the time. You know, to the point where the decedent is literally tapping on the lid of the coffin.
Yeah. Just reminiscing that old the Dennis Miller joke about the coroner. Oh. Had a bad day. One of them came back.
Yeah. The toughest job in America, bank guard in Alaska.
Uh-huh.
You got 50 guys in there. They're all wearing a ski mask. Uh-huh. And conversely, the easiest job, coroner.
Coroner.
If everything went wrong, if the worst thing that happens, maybe you get a pulse.
Yeah, right. Well.
Oh, God, honey, I gained one on the table. Right,
that's what happened. Somebody gained a pulse. Yep,
somebody gained a pulse, and now somebody's going to be out of work.
I just wonder I've never really thought about that. Like, how many people need to say somebody's dead before they're dead?
My experience, it's usually been one.
It's usually one, right?
It's been one.
Just one.
And nobody really quibbles with that unless, you know, the person they say is dead is standing right there shaking their head going, no, I don't think I am.
I don't think so.
Part three, people and their health, involves a famous person, and that's Charles Barkley.
Yeah.
Recently, sure. Been lauded for his impressive weight loss. He's looking a little bit slimmer these days.
Chuck's looking good.
I don't know if you guys caught, but he showed up on the Turner Sports pregame show before the Vegas Knights and Florida Panthers dropped the puck in game four on Saturday night. He talked about what inspired him to lose 60 pounds.
Good for him.
Quoting Charles Barkley, my doctor told me I was fat.
Shaq's been saying that for a while.
Yes,
Chuck,
he has.
By the way,
so I'm down 60 pounds, says Charles Barkley. Quote, she said to me, you know, there's no fat old people, only fat young people.
Mm-hmm.
You don't get this stuff together, Chuck, you're not going to be around. He no. revealed last month he was losing weight with the help of a viral drug not named Ozempic. He says it was thanks to a drug called, is it Mounjaro or Mounjaro, Mounjaro. He told the Pat McAfee show he has lost. He went from 352 pounds to 290.
Yeah, look at him here. He looks great.
He does look great. This Mounjaro is used to, along with diet and exercise, to help regulate blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes. It's the brand name for, I can't pronounce this.
Sure.
Similar to other drugs such as Ozempic and Wegovy, both of which are brand names for this. This was approved initially intended to treat people with chronic obesity, while Ozempic was meant for people with type 2 diabetes.
Have you heard about this Ozempic problem that's happening right now?
No.
I forgot who I was talking to about this. Apparently, Ozempic is hard to get a hold of for diabetic patients because everyone's using it for weight loss.
Okay.
And huge thing, especially out west. California apparently is where all the Ozempic is being used for weight loss, which Ozempic, make more.
Well, yeah, there's that.
Make more.
Yeah, you have a hot market here.
Yeah, right.
By the way, it is not without side effects and other things. Be very, very careful about it. It is not a panacea.
Okay.
Read up on it a little bit as I'm looking at it here. There are some side effects here that you don't want to screw around with.
No, but no, Chuck, not quite to his playing weight there, but his head looks like the old Charles Barkley head.
Maybe some of the inspiration has been with those commercials now that has young Chuck sitting next to Chuck.
Yes, I wouldn't doubt it.
I mean, that computer-generated Charles Barkley, young Charles Barkley, that sits next to current Charles Barkley is...
You starkly see yourself...
Stunningly accurate to what Chuck used to look like.
Probably 90 to 100 pounds heavier post-playing. And, yeah, you see that a couple times during the playoffs. And, yeah, you'll... That's the impetus right there, but good for him.
Yeah.
He looks happy.
He does look happy.
Uh-huh.
You know, he knows that Shaq won't be able to really tee off on the weight as much.
Imagine if he shows up next year for the show, like he drops another like 20, 30 pounds, and he just looks like Kenny Smith when he comes back.
Well, wouldn't that be hilarious?
That'd be great.
At the end of last year, Shaq, by the way, had lost some weight, going from 401 pounds to 365 pounds, walking 30 minutes a day, cutting out bread and pop.
Yeah, these guys are getting to the edge. I mean, that quote you said there.
Yep.
There's old fat people. There's old guys, there's fat people. There's no old fat people.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, his doctor said, you're not going to be around if you don't do something about this.
Good for him.
Shaq talking about a friend of mine called me up and said, you're fat. And then he gave me this guy's name. The guy did some blood work. He was saying, you can do this. You can't do that. More vegetables. Your iron's low. Once I started changing certain things, the weight just began falling off me. But I like that. A friend of mine called me up and said, you're fat.
That's a good friend.
That is a good friend. Most people would be afraid to say that to a man that large.
Nope. But nope, you need a friend like that in your life.
What were his last words? Well, he called Shaq fat. He was killed instantly.
Yeah, I saw you on TV. You're super fat. Knock it off.
Yeah. So Chuck and Shaq dropping some weight.
Hey, that's, they've combined at least 100 pounds between the two of them.
60
so far?
For Chuck himself, and he's still going.
Still going. Awesome.
All right.
And
for any
people.
Of you out there who are trying to do it as well, good luck. Keep at it.
Stick to it. You can do it. Trust me.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you're a living proof. You can do it.
Yeah.
What was that weight drop that you did? 70? We did, 77?
We went 295 down to 209 was when I was at my lowest. We're up to about 230 right now. We gotta bounce back a little bit, but no, it's you can do it. Anybody can do it.
Yeah, our friend John Wallace dropping 86 pounds.
Double T.
Yes, and these guys have all stayed.
Yeah,
have all kept the weight off.
You can
too.
Do it. You can do it. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, I can't jump into any of this.
Well, you're just one of those annoying stick people. You and my dad.
I'm putting that on a business card.
Yeah, annoying stick.
Your dad and I, annoying stick people.
Trying to put on some weight, guys.
Okay. Guilty. 649, News Talk 1440, WROK.
Do you ever discover other...
Zaxby's has been perfecting chicken fingers for 30 years, and now we're going to the sea! Shrimp butterflied and fried to perfection. And a perfect blend of Zax sauce and cocktail sauce called Zaxtail sauce. The perfect southern fried shrimp meal. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.